Welcome to this lecture series in chemical reaction engineering. We'll continue with the problems from the exercise of chapter number 8. Next problem 8.7. Consider the following elementary reaction. A plus B gives R and R plus B gives S. This is again series parallel reaction. We have to solve part A. 1 mole of A and 3 moles of B are rapidly mixed together. 1 mole of A and 3 moles of B. Reaction is very slow, allowing the analysis of decomposition at various times. When 2.2 moles of B remain unreacted, means 0.8 is reacted. 0.2 moles S is present in the mixture. When 2.2 moles of B are analyzed as unreacted, 0.2 moles of S present in the mixture. What should be the composition of the mixture of A, B, R, S when the amount of S present is 0.6 mole? So first 1 mole, 3 moles and this is 2.2 moles remains unreacted. So that means 0.8 is consumed. So this delta Cb is 0.8 and delta Cb by Ca0, because Ca0 is 1 mole, so it is 0.8 moles when Cs is present in the mixture. Okay, Cs is 0.2. So from the design plot we can see here delta Cb by Ca0 0.8. So this line of slope 2, same line we are following, and this is 0.2. So from this diagonal I will move along this and will locate my point on this blue line, which is delta Cb by Ca0 is equal to 0.8. this I will move and locate the point here such that distance between this and this diagonal representing Cs by Ca0, so Cs is equal to 0.2. so here you can see I have located that point and that Cs is equal to 0.2, and here from here to here it is 0.4, and that 0.4 is Ca, and remaining is also 0.4 here, that is Cr. So Cr is 0.4, Ca is 0.4 and Cs is equal to 0.2, and this point of intersection is at K2 by K1 is equal to 0.8. Here K2 by K1 is equal to 0.8. So we have found out this K2 by K1 is equal to 0.8 for this. Okay. So analyze at various times means it is our batch reactor. From the plot, the composition when Cs is equal to 0.6, when Cs is equal to 0.6, again from this we will start from this diagonal and we'll move this, and from this diagonal to K2 by K1 is equal to 0.8, on this line we'll move this horizontally and fix a point where this Cs is 0.6. okay, so this is matching at this intersection, is cutting here. Okay, so this is 0.9 and this is 0.3, so 0.6 means Cr is 0.3 and remaining 0.1 is Ca, and this intersection line, this you have to find out where it cuts, and that will give you further information on this. So Cs is equal to 0.6, Cr is 0.3, C CA is 0.1. Okay, here once this is fixed, CS is equal to 0.6, then on this line of K2 by K1, this profile, this is 0.3 and that is CR, and this remaining is 0.1, that is CA. So we have noted this. CB is equal to 1.5. Okay. Now this CB, again at this point of intersection, I draw a line of slope 2 and this further. So we don't have this extension, but anyway, this is lying in between 1.4 and 1.6 and located roughly at the center of this. So I can say that CB value is 1.5. So CB is equal to 1.5. Now this is the reaction. A plus B gives R and R plus B gives S. To produce 0.6 moles of S. So S is produced in the second reaction only. So for this we need at least 0.6 moles of R and 0.6 moles of B in the second reaction. 0.3 moles are remaining finally here, that we have seen. So 0.6 are required here and 0.3 are remaining, means 0.9 moles of R must have been produced in first reaction. So to produce 0.9 moles of R by the first reaction, you need 0.9 moles of A and 0.9 moles of B. So 0.9 moles of A consume, 0.1 is remaining. When you need 0.9 moles of B also. Okay. So 0.9 moles of B consumed in the first reaction, and in the second reaction 0.6 moles of B are consumed. So total 0.9 and 0.6, 1.5 moles are consumed. So you start with 3 moles. So 3 minus 0.9 minus 0.96 is 1.96, and that we have seen that it matches the value from the figure also. So when 0.6 moles is in the mixture, we have this distribution. CS is equal to 0.6, then CB is 1.5, CA is 0.1 and CR is 0.3. Part B, when 1 mole of A is added bit by bit, very slowly, constant stirring of to 1 mole of B. 1 mole of B is there and B is added, A is added slowly. Left overnight and analyze, 0.5 moles of S found. So if you remember the first plot which we have seen, where only S is formed till complete B is consumed. So R is converted to S as soon as it is formed. So no R is detected as long as B is there. So this indicates that K2 must be much greater than K1. That is what you can say about K2 by K1. C, 1 mole of A, 1 mole of B, equimolar, are thrown together and mixed in a flask. The reaction is very rapid, goes to completion before any rate measurement can be made. So you cannot measure the rate, reaction is very rapid, goes to completion. On analysis of the product, so in between you don't have a data, but products anyway you can analyze, and it is found that 0.25 moles of S is found to be present. So 0.25 moles found to be present. Equimolar, so this CB by CA0 1 goes to completion immediately. So delta CB by CA0 is 1. So on this line, this is the line of slope 2, of delta Cb by Ca0, which is 1. So here on this line, so you have to locate a point such that this S should be 0.25, and you will get a unique location where along this line, you can see here, if you measure this, this is not, if you measure beyond this, this is greater than 0.2. So exact 0.2, only one point of intersection, and here you can see it happens at this point. Where K2 by K1 is 0.4. So here K2 by K1 0.2, 0.3, this is 0.4, this is 0.6, this is 0.8. Okay. Here. So this value, this is 2, this you have to measure. Remaining is corresponding value of CA, and this is corresponding value of CI. But it is asked only about K2 by K1, so K2 by K1 from the plot we get as 0.4. Other values CA, CR, CS also you can report. CS is 0.25. CR will be this value, whatever it is, something like 0.4, 0.5. And between 0.6 and 0.5, okay, and this is 2 point something, so that you can exactly find out from the plot, or you can find out from the calculations quantitative by the models. Model also we have already solved. 8.8, liquid phase reaction of aniline with ethanol produces unwanted monoethyl aniline, unwanted diethyl aniline and wanted monoethyl aniline. So this is desired product and this is undesired product. K1 is 1.25 times K2, so K2 by K1 is 0.8. Equimolar feed is introduced in batch reactor, reaction allowed to goes to completion. Find the concentration of the reactants and product at the end of the run. So we have equimolar feed here, and so delta Cb by Ca0 when reaction goes to completion is 1. So we draw this line of slope 2 overlapping this line originally in the graph representing delta Cb by Ca0 is 1. And K2 by K1 is given as 0.8. So this point of intersection on this curve showing K2 by K1 is equal to 0.8. This point represents CR here, CR by CA0. From here to here it is CS, and then it is CA as usual. So what we do here is, at K2 is equal, K2 by K1 is equal to 0.8, CS is equal to 0.3, CR is equal to 0.4, CA is equal to 0.3. So here, so this line of slope 2 at delta Cb by Ca0 is equal to 1, it crosses here, and this represents 0.4, means CR is 0.4. From here 0.4 to 0.7, so this is 0.3, CS is 0.3, and remaining is 0.3, that is CA is also 0.3. So this can be found out from these design plots. CA 0.3, CS is 0.3, and CR is also 0.4, total is 1. To obtain, so here first reaction, aniline plus ethanol, monoethyl aniline plus water. So Ca is 0.3, that is remaining one. So converted is 0.7, and same monoethylamine find will be 0.7 moles and water will be 0.7 moles. Cs is produced only in the second reaction. So in the second reaction, to produce 0.3 moles of S, that is diethyl aniline, we need 0.3 ethanol and 0.3 monoethylamine. Okay. So this 0.7 is formed, out of that 0.3 is consumed here. So remaining is 0.4. This CS formed is 0.3. CA is not involved in the second reaction, so unreacted 0.3 of this. Okay. Ethanol 0.7 used here and 0.3 used here, so complete 1 mole is used. So B, this is 0 at the end, and this water formation will be 0.7, 0.3, 1. So to obtain 0.3 moles of S in second reaction, we need 0.3 moles of R and 0.3 moles of B, and as explained earlier, this will be the concentration of all the species taking part in the reaction. Part B, find monoethanolamine. So part A was into a batch reactor, so we use this chart, you can see, for batch or plug flow. Second, now mixed flow. So we have to use the chart for mixed flow reactor. For an alcohol to aniline feed ratio 2:1. Okay, alcohol, that is B to A, is 2:1. 70% conversion of alcohol, 70% conversion of B. So this is 1 mole of A, 2 moles of B, and this is giving R and W. So this is used in excess. Stoichiometry is 1:1:1:1. So we are using it in excess. R plus B, again stoichiometry is 1:1:1:1. 70% conversion of B. So B is 2 moles, 70% is converted, that means consumed is 1.4. So delta Cb is 1.4. Ca0 is 1. So delta Cb by Ca0 is 1.4. So we have to locate the point for delta Cb by Ca0 1.4 and K2 by K1 0.8, that intersection point we have to find out. And we are using now MFR chart for mixed flow reactor. So this 1.4, delta Cb by Ca0 1.4 and K2 by K1 is 0.8 here. So this point we have found out, and here you can find that this value of Cr, Cs and Ca. Okay. So from the plot, these values are Ca is equal to 0.2, Cr is equal to 0.2, and remaining Cs is 0.6. And what is asked? Ratio, aniline feed ratio of 2:1. Find the ratio of mono to diethanol. So mono is R and di is S. So Cr by Cs. Cr is 0.2, Cs is 0.6. So ratio is 1:3, that is 0.333. Next, part C. Now plug flow reactor. So plug flow reactor, so you will use the design chart for plug flow reactor. What will be the conversion of two reactants when the concentration of monoethanolamine is highest? Now this monoethanolamine is our product R. So we will consider equimolar fluid. Ca is equal to 1, Cb is equal to 1. So using the plot K2 by K1 is equal to 0.8 that we have to use in this case also. The point at which CR is maximum. So you have to locate that point and then obtain CR CSC. So you can see here where this point is maximum. We have to find out. So, on 0.8 K2 by K1, this is the point of CR max. And at that point of CR max, the value is 0.4 and we get CA is equal to 0.33 and CS is equal to 0.27. Okay. Now here, we'll draw a line of slope 2 here, slope 2 parallel to these lines, and this is between 0.8 and 1. Okay, 0.8 and 1. So you can extend it here, and if you extend this line, roughly approximate value of this delta CB by CA0 minus delta CB by CA0 is 0.92. This is approximate value. Okay. Conversion, what we have to find out? What will be the conversion of the two reactants? So this is 0.67. XA is 1 minus CA by CA0 is 0.67. And the total conversion of ethanol, this we can find out here. Okay. This is already found out and make this space less. So, this has been already found out and it is delta CB by CA0. So, conversion is, it represents amount consumed. So, in this case, as long as CA0 is equal to 1, this value is 0.92. So, XA is 0.67 and this value is 0.92. In part 1, you can note that equimolar feed is introduced and reaction is allowed to proceed to completion. So, when reaction is going to completion and equimolar feed, then this is 1. Okay. In this part, what we have done, nothing is this equimolar feed. So, we have considered this as 1 and this as 1. And about the reaction going to completion or what, that we don't know. So, that value is not known. Delta CB by CA0 is not known. Whereas, we have another information. What will be the conversion when the concentration is highest? So, at CR max, which value is 0.4, we have found out CA and CS. Okay. So, what we have done, in this case, plug flow reactor chart we have used, and this point of maxima on K2 by K1 is equal to 0.8 here, we have noted. And so, this is CR, from this to diagonal is CS and remaining is CA, and those values we have reported here. And then we have found at this point of intersection, we have moved this line further with slope 2. And we have found that approximately this is at 0.2. So if you extend this line, you can see it will give you this value of 0.92 somewhere here. and using that value of 0.92, xA 1 minus CA by CA0, that is 0.67, and xB will get directly as 0.92. 8.9. Monoethanol aniline can be produced in vapor phase in fluidized bed using natural bauxite as solid catalyst. The elementary reactions are shown in the previous problem. Same we will use. Using equimolar feed of aniline and ethanol in the fluidized bed produces 3 parts of monoethanolamine and 2 parts of diethanolamine. So this is S and this is R. So 3 parts of R and 2 parts of S for 40% conversion of aniline. That is our A. So XA is 40%. Mixed flow of the gas in fluidized bed. Find K2 by K1 and the concentration ratio of the reactants and products at the exit. So here 40% conversion of aniline in the reaction is taking place. So 40% of ethanol will be converted. So out of 0.6 moles which are unreacted ethanol, so in the reaction A plus B giving R, 40% conversion of A means 40% is conversion. So at the end of the reaction, unconverted A will be 0.6, unconverted B will be 0.6, and formed R will be 0.4, because 1 mole converted of A giving you 1 mole of R. So at the end of the reaction, this is the distribution. Okay. Now what is mentioned here, this 0.4 is formed. So if you split this into 5 parts from the first reaction, it is distributed as 3 parts of R and 2 parts of S. Means 3 parts R and 2 parts S. It is given in the problem statement. So 3 parts of R means 3 by 5 into 0.4, that is 0.24. So concentration of R at the end of the second reaction, it will be 0.24. 2 parts, that is 0.16, converts into S, that is 0.16. So this is formed. So 2 by 5 into 0.4 is 0.16. So distribution is as given in the problem statement. CA, you know, unreacted, that is 0.6. Now this we know, this we know. What about CB? CB, we start with 1. 0.4 is converted or reacted in the reaction 1. And 0.16 in reaction 2. So 1 minus 0.4 minus 0.16, that is 0.44. So at the end of the reaction 1, this is formation. This R formed is 0.24 and unreacted B finally is 0.44. Okay. So B reacted in the first reaction is 0.4. Reacted in the second reaction is 0.16 and remaining is 0.44. So delta CB is 0.56. CB is 0.44. CB0 is 1, so minus delta CB is 0.56. That means amount of B consumed is 0.56. CA0 is 1. So with the slope of 2 for this ratio of 0.56, okay, so this is line between 0.5 and 0.6, somewhere here 0.5, 0.56 you can draw, and this line of slope 2 ओके सो what information we have CR is 0.24 okay on this line if I locate the point for CR is equal to 0.24 so you can draw this horizontal line CR is equal to 0.24 and where it cuts okay this point and this you can see this lies on k2 by k1 is equal to 1 okay so this is 0.24 ca and cs also you can check ca is 0.6 cs is 0.16 so ca from this point to this point it is 0.6 and this is 0.14 so k2 by k1 is equal to 1 that is obtained from MFR plot so in this case what was asked is find k2 by k1 and the concentration of the reactants and the products that we have formed out so concentration ratios we have determined as long as CA0 is equal to 1 concentration and ratio of concentration CA by CA0 CR by CA0 CS by CA0 remains same so this we have reported next problem under the action of mixed enzymes reactant A is converted to products A in presence of enzyme gives R in presence of enzyme gives S K1 K2 N1 is equal to N2 is equal to 1 that means these are first order reactions where the rate constants are dependent on pH of the system two parts we have to solve the reactor setup plug flow mix flow or stage mix flow and what uniform pH level we should use part B if it were possible to change the pH level along the plug flow reactor or from stage to stage mix flow units in what direction would you change the pH level so we'll have to answer two questions for these two problems 8.10 and 8.11 it is given that K1 and K2 both are functions of pH K1 is pH square minus 8 pH plus 23 for the values between 2 and 6. So, we'll take the values of pH between 2 and 6, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. K2, R is the desired product and K2 is pH plus 1. So, K1 found out by this formula, pH is equal to 2. So, pH square, 2 square, 8 into 2 plus 23, all values of K1 have been found out. K2 is pH plus 1. So 2 plus 1, 3, then 4, 5, 6, 7. So these values have been found out. Ratio you can find out K1 by K2. And this ratio is found out. R is desired product. That means K2 should be as high as possible. And more precisely we'll say K2 also should be low. Only K1 giving you high. Comparatively it should be higher. So K1 by K2 this ratio should be high. So K1 by K2 is highest for pH is equal to 2, this highlighted, okay, that value is 3.67. So the pH which would be maintained slightly higher than 2, okay, slightly or around 2 you can say. Why we are not saying less than this? Because it is given in the range of 2 to 6 only. So, not below 2 but slightly above 2 you will maintain. This will give maximum R. MFR we should use to maintain the pH throughout the reactor as 100% mixing and uniform pH maintenance can be done only in PFR. Part B, we have to answer, that is pH is required to be kept higher at constant, so PFR will not be preferred. So MFR you can use, or MFR in few number of stages you can use, but not very high number of mixed flow reactors in series, because that will be again leading to plug flow performance. 8.11. Now K1 and K2, these equations have been changed. K1 is pH plus 1 and K2 is pH square minus 8 pH plus 23. So K1, K2 have been determined. K1 by K2 ratio also we have found out. Here S is desired product. S is desired product. So here K1 by K2 ratio, though we have found out, it is not playing major role. K2 higher is required because S is to be formed. But S is formed from R. That means K1 also should be comparatively high. This ratio is not a very important factor when S is designed. So both K1 and K2 should be maintained high. So instead of ratio, we will concentrate on this and we will see. Here if you compare, at pH is equal to 6, K1 is highest, and here this is also 11, this is highest. So at pH is equal to 2 also it is 11. So both the conditions are satisfied here. So here we will maintain around 6, maybe slightly higher, or just around 6 you can maintain. So slightly higher beyond this range we don't have any idea, but immediately if you make it lower than this, it will go towards lower side of K2 and this. So although we don't know what will be the fate of this beyond 6, still we'll maintain at 6 or slightly higher. MFR should be used to maintain pH throughout the reactor as 100%. Mixing and uniform pH can be easily maintained in MFR. So same argument, same answers for this also, because anyway we have to maintain pH around 6 uniform, and in earlier case pH around 2, and that too uniform. So to maintain the uniform pH we have to do this. So here we come to the end of chapter 8. Now few topics, that is more complex series parallel combination, then big reactions and few other reactions are there, and there are few problems based on those reactions in the exercise. We are not including this here as per the curriculum for this chemical reaction engineering 1 paper in our syllabus. So we'll continue with the next chapter in our next lecture. But later on to this lecture series, remaining part of the chapter 8 and the problems based on chapter 8 will be added, but that at a later stage when we will complete our prescribed curriculum, that is chapter number 9, temperature effects, pressure effects, and chapter number 11, that is introduction to non-ideal flow. So we stop here and we'll continue with chapter number 9 in our next lecture.